lot of the transmission that's occurring occurs indoors. And so being outside is really great. And so the first thing you want to do when you're outdoors is make sure you're socially distancing between different households. You can be close to people from your household, but try to maintain a distance of at least 6 feet between people from different households. The air outside is basically an infinite volume of air. I know it's not infinite. I mean, you could calculate how much air is in the atmosphere, but it's a huge amount of air. And so that dilutes the virus. Whereas indoors, there's much more limited volume of air. And that's why most of the transmission takes place indoors. And then make sure to wash your hands frequently. You can use soap and water, but it's easier to just carry around a little bottle of alcohol hand sanitizer. Be careful though if you have to go indoors for anything. For example, if you have to go into a restroom, make sure you're wearing a mask. You're gonna be indoors, you may not be able to socially distance, and so make sure you wear a mask in that situation. If you get in a raft or in a kayak and you're close to people, do that by household. So don't mix households, and that helps socially distance. And then you can enjoy those activities. For barbecues or birthday parties, obviously those are best done outdoors. So if you can do those in the backyard, that's great, or the front yard, that's great. And that helps you maintain that outdoor environment where the virus is dilute. And then you can also, there's more room, and so it helps you social distance and maintain that 6 foot distance. Indoors, it's gonna be more of a challenge. And then, of course, if you're there for a prolonged period of time, you might have to use the restroom. That'll bring you indoors. So certainly, if you have to do that, wear a mask. I think for daycare and summer camps, that's an individual decision that families need to make. They have to see what protocols are in place, and they have to see what value they place on that for their children. And there's certainly a lot of social value in terms of doing that for their children, in terms of socialization for their children. But it may depend on the circumstances of the family. So you can imagine a family who everybody in the household is young and healthy and has no risk factors for severe disease. They might make one decision, and another family who might live in with extended family in their household with somebody who's maybe elderly and has comorbidities that increase their risk for disease, they might just think that the risk isn't worth it.